one for Crystal's boy.
Okay.
One for Crystal's boy.
Yeah.
Do you have some batteries for your camera?
Sure.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure I got some of the camera. Okay, your buddy probably needs a break, but no, I'm going to just fall off on him.
Jill, did you get your ticket?
I got my ticket.
Will you bring it?
Is Buddy's leash in there?
Yeah, it's on her.
You got lots left, Dad. Stacy, is it Shauna? Is that your moving camera?
Mine is here.
One for Bill and one for Cindy. Shauna.
We're going to make it home.
You gonna read from the book too?
Do kids get one too, John, or what? Do they pay for drinks? Kids? Well, I thought, but those kids. You can have pop if you want. You can write. You got some, okay. Yeah. Crystal. Crystal. The kids.
Yeah, I guess it's different.
Slimes.
Are they really?
They go out of it yourself.
There's a, they call something else too somewhere else.
Oh, I see.
Slimes. Things to drink.
Yeah, that's what I was.
Aren't you specials at the Royal?
The Royal is on what town is that?
No, it's a bar in the shop.
The ham.
Yeah, just ready to print it.
Or it'll blow your candles out.
The tiniest little pen.
What an overachiever.
How many do you need in the kitchen of those tickets? Yes.
Huh?
How many more tickets in the kitchen? Dad's got more.
Jesse got one?
Yeah. Just take them. They'll give to the kitchen.
Yeah, one for you and one for, or one
yeah.
For mom.
Yeah, I got one. Dad, you got one? You get one.
Yeah. So, have you got a ticket?
Yep. Okay. There's yours. Okay.
Okay. One for Diane.
Take another. Sure.
Okay, I'll grab a drink.
Did you get a ticket? Did you get a ticket?
No, I didn't get a ticket.
Okay, Dad bought a drink for everybody. Yep.
Well,
ginger ale or whatever, you can use it tomorrow or whatever.
Those clocks dirty.
Tracy?
No, Jen's getting me mine, Dad.
Oh, okay. And did you get one?
Nope.
Okay, oops.
Thank you.
So how come we got...
I'll look at the breakfast. Or here, I've got a bag over here. Throw them in the bag.
So you have the other half.
You've got champagne there.
No, but I want a beer. Well, we'll drink this with the toast, then.
Yeah.
It's for the toast.
I don't know.
Do you want toast, Dad, or?
No, just...
Well, hang on, please. I don't
toast,
know.
Toast, no. Have breakfast.
Brought their dogs?
You wouldn't miss it for the world, Grandma.
Chuck, joy to the world. Chucky baby. They came a long way from Calgary too. And Ducky came, I guess, the furthest.
No. Shauna.
Hello. Oh, Shauna. Victoria. Right.
They both go.
And the kids worked hard. And Jesse. Wait, I haven't finished with this holiday.
No, you can't skip your grandchildren. You start on them, you got to finish them off.
No. Now, Dale, Crystal there with the new baby. We're very glad you came. Very interesting little guy. Keeps us all busy.
Yep.
And Nolan, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
you in the family. And Bobby, Jesse, and Regina. The city, Windy City.
I think that's New York.
And Jesse. Jesse, Jerry, Dennis with his tribe. Dennis and Tracy and Kelsey and Kylie and Paula, we're glad to have you.
I
had a good time in Victoria. Excellent time. And what else? Who did I miss? Beth with her new motorhome.
Yeah.
Oh, there you are.
And nice to meet Earl's new girlfriend and Chuck's new girlfriend, and we met Jesse's girlfriend and Ryan's girlfriend, and oh my God.
There's a lot of new faces here.
And what?
My girlfriend.
Oh. And Earl, he did lots of work getting the yard already, and then when Bev could jump in on the tractor, she did.
Hey, I did it too.
Everybody came and did, every one of the seven did something to the yard.
I didn't.
And to the house. And to the house.
You drove into the yard.
You parked there.
And then I'm just thinking of some things that happened, like Shauna.
I did happen, didn't I?
And Ryan that I took to the park, Dad and I, when we went out of our way to go to Fishing Lake Park, and then they took a nice little slingshots and they kicked us out. Kicked us out of the park. Crystal, how she drove my new car, my Fifth Avenue, and scratched the whole side of it up. And
upon your insistence.
Chuck, I should tell some stories about him.
Who?
When he was little, we used to go to the lake every year. Maxine had a cabin there. And, of course, we'd take along Bev's three, which were hellions.
Yep,
they got all infected mouths and everything else.
I thought I could
finish Chuck off on winter. I put him on a toboggan, and there was
With Josh?
Yeah. He's not here.
Yeah.
I put him on a steep hill, and I thought he'd maybe slow down a little bit on the way down. At the bottom of the hill was the lake, and then a big ramp where he went over, and onto the lake. So he never slowed down at all. They gained speed, and they gained speed, and they come to this big ramp, and they went way up and down, and I never heard nothing. There was no sound. And then all of a sudden, these bloody heads came up screaming.
Yeah, Josh even told me. He loved that, though. He loved his speed.
Oh, yeah.
You're not getting off! I think he held me on there. Yeah, we flew pretty good on that one.
And I used to beat Jesse when he was little. He'd come up to the farm. He'd make those crazy things.
And Sean. Oh, you're in the basement.
Oh, yeah. They put a plays on in the basement every Christmas. And we've got video of you, too. You were dancing down there. You never saw a dancer like him. You just cut up a storm. Really good dancer. And they put this play on, the Chain Gang. What was it? Anyway, we came down to the basement. Here they were on with these chains. Saws and skidoo suits, and we had to come down and see the play. You remember that, Jeff? Because your mom was so mad. She thought that was terrible, having chainsaws. Were you in that, Chuck?
I don't know
where you were or not.
You were the producer, Chuck.
And, yeah.
You were probably the producer, Chuck.
Oh yeah, the producer. And what can I tell about Earl and the wasp?
We know.
Beer bottles in the garage and the trucks.
Oh yeah. But anyway, I went to visit Earl and Diane and Dave and I heard about these wasps that grow in that are in the all the attics and that if they sting you, you'll die. That they're poison wasps or something. So I saw this thing in their house. It was spring yet. And I said, oh, I bet you that's one of those wasps. And he went to school. What did you do? Wrote a story?
I wrote a story about it. And then you made me send it into the university to get it analyzed. You sent it back saying it was a common house fly.
But that wasn't the worst of it. When he wrote the story and he turned it in, his teacher didn't believe him and didn't give him a passing mark on the story because he hadn't told a true story.
Oh. It was the truth. He used to crawl out the top window, which his parents didn't know.
Nope.
Always to get out that window and out onto the street and go somewhere. Right? Did you do that a lot of times?
Yeah, a few times, yeah. Yeah.
Liza squealed on you.
That's okay.
Where, in Dominique?
Yeah.
Or were you sneaking out to garden raid or I don't know. Whatever seems to be out of there and going garden raid maybe. Oh yeah. Stealing signs. It's tough. Yeah.
Whatever you can steal.
Oh, yeah.
And Dale.
You did.
When Dale was little.
You snuck out the window too?
Uh-oh.
Thought you had two perfect angels, didn't you? At least one.
And Shauna had a little shawl that she wouldn't park, but she sucked on it all the time. She was on the collar brief.
Her little blanket.
A little blanket. So I said to her, I thought, I'll fix her. She'll listen to me and get rid of it. I said, Shauna, we'll get rid of that, won't we? Yeah. You will. You won't want it anymore. No. So I threw it out the window. And come nightfall, she wanted that little blanket so bad I had to go find it. She
you
got
were driving?
It back again. Hey?
You're driving when you threw it out?
No.
Oh,
out her, they lived in an apartment. She lived down. But she got it back anyway.
I heard about my own children.
Start
on that.
We don't want to be
I can tell some good ones on Mac and Diane. Bev and Dale. We thought he was pretty smart when he was a little older than that, that he could go up to get out of our crib at home and slide down the rails and get out. He was only in diapers. So he got very sick one time and we had to take him to the hospital. And they couldn't keep him in the crib. He'd go up and come down the side. So they decided, well, we'll fix him. We'll put a blanket on the top. So they tied blankets all over the top of the crib. The nurses did. Well, no, he got out of that. So next thing they did, they put a board on the top. I don't know if they kept him in or not.
They ended up tying him down.
Eh?
I remember they ended up tying him in there.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah.
Straight tied.
He'd show up at the nurse's desk in the middle of the bed.
He couldn't keep him in the bed. Well, I guess that's it.
Each one of the grandchildren, and it'll pass around to each one of your children. We've got it a memory book. I don't know who's got it right now.
It's right here.
It's right there. And they've written in it their favorite memories of their grandparents and going visiting you or whatever. I don't know. I haven't read them. So, and that book will be for you guys as a memory of your.
Well, thank you very much.
And now.
I'm sure we'll enjoy it.
We are going to have Duffy, Bev, sing.
Really?
Are you ready?
We didn't even practice.
You guys don't need to practice. And Dennis.
Shine, shine, let it shine. Will the circle be unbroken by my Lord, by and by? There's a banner overweighted in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Give Jesus all that fame, tell him what what you want. Get Jesus on that main line. Tell him what you want. Get Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Let him call him up and tell him what you want. Oh, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, 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 let it shine. Let it shine, 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 let it shine.
Years and years.
Do I pick, Paula?
No, that's okay.
Neither do we.
Well, I don't.
Yeah, my buggy got a hole in it.
book has got a hole in it. If my book has got a hole in it, I can't buy no beer. Then I went up on the mountain, I looked down in the sea. I seen the crabs and the fishes doing the bebop bee. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. I can't buy no beer. Yeah, I'm standing on the corner with a bucket in my hand. I'm gonna find me a woman who can let loose of my man. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. I can't buy no beer. Everybody, yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. Yeah, my bug has got a hole in it. I can't buy no milk. That's pretty good. When you are sad and lonely and have no place to go, come with me, sweet mama, and bring along some dough, and we'll go honky tonkin', honky tonkin', honky.
There's
a lot of things I am very grateful for. Start crying. And one is being able to do what I want to do from when I was a child, and that's the gift you guys gave me and all of us. And we were never stopped from doing what we actually wanted to do. And I wouldn't be as happy as I am. I may not make a lot of money, but I think I do what I want to do, and we're all free spirits. And Bev gave me the gift of the guitar, and I think everyone else, you know, has contributed and supported each other over the years, and that's one thing we should be grateful for, is these two people here supporting us. Never stop.
Hear that lonesome whippoorwill, he sounds to blue the fly. The midnight train is whining low, I'm so lonesome I could cry. I'm when time goes crawling by. The midnight train behind the clouds to hide its face and cry. Did you ever see a robin weep when begin to die? Like me, he's lost the will to live. I'm so lonesome I could cry. The silence of a falling star lights up the pearl.
Surely find another to pull wild fellows.
me.
Chopsticks.
Dennis, would you like to come up and present the balls to Dad, please?
Well, he said Dad's balls.
Nicely put. We figured you need a new set of balls.
Yeah. Get pictures of you?
Right here, they got balls out.
Yeah, because your balls wear out after a little while. Significant of your illustrious baseball career, we thought it was appropriate to give you some signed balls. one's from us kids, and the rest from grandchildren. So, pick the other one.
Don't ever lose your balls,
Dad. That's it. Thank you. Got an extra set now.
Put your balls on a pedestal. Count your balls.
You think you still got one more pitch in you?
Yeah.
Hold your balls up high so we can take a picture there.
It's still in good.
Well, I'm going to read from the book.
You're going to read from the book?
I'm going to do a reading.
The holy book?
Or oh. Do a reading.
This is the book that...
Girl, give me a pulpit.
We're all...
Thank you, Dennis.
We're all writing our memories of.
Here, Dennis.
Oh my gosh.
This is from. Anyway, we all wrote memories of just a few points that we thought were. Well, then you're gonna have to. You're gonna have
I'll
to
just
speak for your head.
No, I'll just.
Memories. Just things that stood out in our minds from our years growing up. So anyway, the things I wrote down were the garden at Molly's, shelling endless peas from endless large boxes of peas that we picked in a hot living room in our little house in town. Swimming at the old sand pits on hot summer days because we didn't have a swimming pool here, so we used to go up to the sand pits where there was water and get the itch. Mama teaching me grade 3, which was fall for me. Not so good for mom. Playing catch with dad, and dad throwing knuckleballs that seemingly glide and take 10 or 15 seconds to get 50 feet, and which moved all over the place. And the relative ease with which dad would catch the ball. So you'd throw him the ball as hard as you possibly could. Snap it out of here.
Remember that, Dad?
Dad's goofy jokes, dry humor. Always there was a joke out of thin air, made out of nothing, that Dad could do. No one has quite a sense of humor like Dad. Mom making me go to school, to summer school, after I failed grade 10. Thanks, Mom.
Oh, yeah. Cost me a bit.
Nothing like a kick in the ass.
And then you got 99.
No, that was me that got 99.
Oh, right.
Trip to Yorkton with Dad to go to a Yorkton Terriers hockey camp. Thanks, Dad. Thanks for trying, but didn't make her. It was fun. Maybe Dad and I got to stay in a hotel room and...
Not too much.
Well, you fell asleep and I stole about 2 of your cigarettes and put them in the can. And...
I didn't miss those 2, did
he? He never missed his cigarettes.
Chasing foul balls at Dad's ball games. Another thing just kind of popped into my head, speaking of baseball, was after the ball games, sometimes the ball team would come over to the house and all these guys with pot bellies would be laying in the grass with beer in one hand, laying down in the grass and a blade of grass and sticking out of the side of their mouth. Just something that popped into my head. With their uniforms on. Yeah. Anyway, that's mine. Who's next here? John?
No, we're not all getting up in the earring at all.
Well, it's...
Can't read your writing.
Read your writing, and it's you don't have to stand up. Just sit down and read it.
Okay. Well, Grandpa, first of all, I'd like you to know that I did do an impersonation of you at Liza's wedding.
Yeah, she did.
What is something like, congratulations. That's about it. But you were there. Well, I had a lot of memories from Grandma and Grandpa Max's place. I remember a lot going over to Grandma Nordic's and crying because I wanted to be a Grandma Max.
Oh, good, thank you.
For getting angry at me. Grandma taking me and Ryan to the old Englefeld school and doing pottery in the basement there.
Oh, right.
Weekend after weekend. One time the water was so rusty at the farm, she tried to get us into an old bucket and bath in it. We refused, and I don't think we fit either, but I remember one time, I think before I was in kindergarten, Grandma took me to school with her when she was subbing a class. I don't know what grade it was, but it must have been grade 3 or something. They were a few years older than me, and I wowed them with my paper mache tulips or something like that. Got in a fight with the boy as well at recess.
Probably pounded piss up.
Probably. Later on, a few years later, I was drinking beers with him. Realized who he was. You jerk. Grandma taking us to Gorley's and killing rabbits crazy with the BB gun, and then Grandpa helping us skin them. Grandpa taking us out to the old hospital and gathering wood and stuff to make forts. Every summer we'd come to find our fort torn down and again and we'd have to build a new one.
Yeah, right.
All my meals being gourmet chips accustomed to me.
You better remember
Thanksgiving
that.
And Christmas, everyone else is having turkey and Shauna got her Fried chips.
Yeah.
And crafts.
Yeah.
The crafty crafts that Grandma taught me how to do my art, or Grandpa helping us build our boxes and whatever it was that we built in the basement there. Grandma and Grandpa's was my best thing ever growing up.
Yep, it was.
Summertime's there. It's great.
We're glad to have you too.
And we waited on you guys.
And some of my memories of Grandma and Grandpa was spending every summer at the farm, helping Grandpa cut down trees, like caraganas, trees, trimming them every summer, and shooting holes in every lawn ornament he ever made, or anything else on the farm.
Beautiful lawn ornaments, real old holes.
I remember Grandma taking us to the pool to swim every day, and to the gym to play floor hockey or whatever with the kids sometimes, when it was closed. Staying up late and sneaking rebels from the freezer and sticking them to her mouth, and then having to wake you up to get them off.
She called us the Night Riders.
And just having the best time of my life every summer I was out here.
I used to ride you on my feet. You used to come to our bedroom early in the morning. We'd see these patter, patter, patter down the hall into the bed.
Did you then
I'd give you the ride.
Ride the horse, then across, and then I'd throw you away up in the air. Best thing ever, running down that hallway into Grandma's bed.
Yep,
in the morning. Just imagine Grandpa was saying something when he was snoring. I always thought it was, ah. I was trying to figure out what he was trying to tell me. Freak me out sometimes.
Well, I haven't done my writing yet either, so I'm just going to speak, and then I have to hope we remember to put everything in the book when we write it. I guess my earliest memory is coming out to where,
sorry.
No, not one of the earliest memories is coming out to where the house is now, I think. Is that where we went to get the corn that just stole from somebody's field?
And we had a garden way out in the country.
Oh,
yeah. And so then she tells me, Mom tells me, get that corn husked in the back of the car. So what am I supposed to do with the corn husks? Throw them out the window. So there I am sitting in the back of the car, and I don't know what grade I was in. It's pretty small. Husking this corn and throwing the corn husks out the window. And then suddenly this siren goes on behind us. Pulls Mom over. You're littering. Turns around and says, what are you doing back there? You're throwing stuff on the highway.
But you were smart.
And I was smart, and I said, I was only doing what you told me to, Mom. I don't remember if you got a ticket for that or not, though.
She just gave me one more chance.
Gave you one more chance.
It was a warning.
I think growing up with figure skating and music lessons, and I was the only one of us that got voice lessons, not that anybody would know. Did you get voice lessons too?
Yeah, I did too.
I got the better voice lessons.
Did you
ask?
No.
And piano lessons and going over and practicing at Mrs. Hamill's house, because we didn't have a piano and Mrs. Hamill did, and Maxine went over there too all the time. And I remember Mrs. Hamill had a book called The Robe, and I read that whole book when I was there with about this thick.
Instead of practicing.
And figure skating lessons, and Dad taking us to the rink, and I think it must have been about 5, and setting up those tires and things in the rink and making us skate around the tires so that we would develop good curve training or something.
You did that?
Yep.
I don't know.
Say yes.
Yeah.
I guess growing up there was a lot of good things that happened, and you grew and developed. I remember Mom sending me in when we had our, I don't remember what grade, was that grade 12? We got the, Mrs. Sproul gave us our English test, and she hadn't taught one whole book, and 40% of the test was on it, the departmental, so nearly everybody failed it, and I went in and took it at summer school and got 99. I was the one that got 99.
I saved you.
Yeah, you saved me. And then how mad you got at Mrs. Stroh when she was proclaiming so proudly that she had had a student that got 99% on a departmental, and figured she didn't deserve that. So anyway, it was, and then going to university and getting all those gorgeous food packages every weekend, which we would have gone sort of hungry without, you know, macaroni and cheese days, and living with Maxine and having Maxine look after me when I got mononucleosis and couldn't go to school and was dead and out. Anyway, there's a lot of good memories, and I think that you can be very proud of the family that you have raised, because I think that each one of us has accomplished what we set out to do, and I think that in our own ways, so I think that, and we are very proud to have you as parents, so thank you.
Thank you.
She
needs
the pulpit.
Oh. Well, she's going to the pulpit.
Yeah, I'm going to the pulpit.
You want music?
Do you want the mic? Oh, please.
Lights.
Should we all say hallelujah now?
This is a memory that I don't think Dad remembers, but when Earl and Diane and I were really little, maybe 2, 3, something like that, I think it was every Sunday morning, he'd take us all into bed with him, and he'd read us the funnies. And then we'd listen to this German song about this baby crying or something, or laughing.
Yeah.
And every Sunday we waited for that song to come on the radio and fooled around in bed. And I remember you were always the one who took us in there and read us the funnies every Sunday morning. And we thought that was the greatest thing. But he doesn't remember that, but I do. And then the other long ago memory, I remember Mom putting us on her bike, Earl, Diane, and I. And she had a pillow on the back, and somebody sat in the front, and she stood up, and somebody sat on the seat, and then she took us on these picnics. And I always thought we went so far, but actually we just went like down the road to the tracks where all the hobos came. We had to look at, we had this little picnic, and we watched the hobos.
Sometimes we went on the Catholic steps.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went to the Catholic church, man.
And I can remember living in the Teetridge with Mom and Auntie Terry and her little baby and Earl. And Earl was in a crib. And Auntie Terry, she just kept me on that pot for like, I think, 12 hours a day. And then she'd have to sort of like suction me off of it. And I'd be going around on the floor on that. I can remember doing that.
That was training.
Yeah. And those are some really early memories. You guys having lots of parties, having lots of fun. Having lots of fun growing up, everybody playing jokes on each other. And Dad and his water fights, and Mom gets mad. And we always had lots of water fights with us, throwing water in the house and out. And yeah, just lots of fun, lots of laughing, joking, parties, lots of good times.
Revels every Sunday night.
And then Diane and I got bad about when we were 14, 15. Then things changed. And then you're grounded. Wash the walls. For a few years. And then they got used to teenagers. And then everybody else kind of got less and less disciplined than we did.
By the time we got to meet it, we couldn't give two shits.
Yeah.
Do whatever you want.
And that's for it for me. I have lots and lots of memories of the lake and everything.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So but we could just go on and on. And anyway, so I'll let somebody else talk. There's lots of kids, so.
Lots. Never ends, you guys.
You get to pass the book.
One of the things that I always think about from when I was growing up, and one of the things I like to reflect on, is that when I was young, I never stayed in a place for more than 2 years, lived in a place for more than 2 years with my mom teaching and moving around. But one thing that we could always count on was Christmas at Watson. And whether I was 6 years old and we were playing, Chuck and I and Josh were playing floor hockey in Grandma's gym, I always used to look forward to that. I used to sit behind the back seat of the Dodge Dart when Mom drove down at 20 miles an hour for 18 hours to
Don't
get to Watson. But all I could talk about the whole way there was playing floor hockey with Chuck and Josh and being at the farm and seeing the Christmas lights when we drove in the driveway. So for me, when I think about my grandparents and I think about Watson, I think about Christmas. And you know what, I'll do my best for the rest of my life never to miss a Christmas at Watson, because when I look back on my childhood, that's the first memory that comes through my brain. And I have that feeling, and it gives me little tingles, and I thank you very much and the whole family for having such wonderful Christmases.
Well, thank you.
So thank you very much.
Next time you bring your children.
Pressure's on.
So in grade four, first period, my grandma walks in.
No, grade three.
Is it grade three?
Yeah.
With Matt. And she looks at us and she says, "You guys are a sorry bunch. You guys look sluggish." And she made us push all the desks to the side. And we line danced for 2 classes. And after that, I won every competition of who had the coolest grandma, definitely. One thing I'll always remember about Grandpa is always the incredible wit every time I say something to you. And you still keep it.
Yeah, still does. Thank you, Jess.
That's it.
How many of your grandchildren did you teach your children? It was Jesse, it was Josh, it was Liza,
Jenny.
It was Nathan,
Jenny.
Jenny.
Five
of them. Dale.
I'm not a grandchild.
That's your own kid.
I'm your own kid.
Okay, but six of five grandchildren.
Dale, yeah.
And Dennis.
The old school. You taught all your own kids. You had five of your grandchildren.
No,
you
taught me.
I never taught Earl.
Oh, yeah.
No, you had Team
Warner.
No, and Leroy when it was Leroy.
Oh, yeah, right. Grade three.
You never taught me.
How come you came to Leroy?
Because I couldn't get along with Mrs. Zacharias.
Oh, you didn't like
Mrs. Zacharias?
Really? She knew my mother was a teacher.
Oh,
she knew.
So I've got lots of memories too. Same with all my sisters. Times of the week.
Forever.
I think I'm 8 years old too.
You don't know, maybe your mother.
Could be. I don't know. Me and my dad worked so many years together.
Yeah, that's
right. I can remember in good moments. Always treated the family.
Good cook, Errol.
Pardon?
Good cook.
Have a good time. Oh, it's a nice place.
So you went lost with Dad. Did you?
Oh.
Yeah.
She's born on the baseball.
Okay. Born on a ball.
You need a new set of balls too now?
Oh, yeah, I do. That's like a personal.
Left
with Crystal.
Beth.
Beth.
Beth. Yeah. When you sang hey.
You can say more.
I got quite a few memories of Mom and Dad also. I can remember all the camping trips every summer. Always loaded up the station wagon. Way we went, all over the mountains and down to the States and stuff.
After Dad worked on the light square of the day.
Right.
Yeah.
The day.
Sorry.
I remember following Dad around all the ball games and ball tournaments and Sturgis and all over the place. And that was the highlight of the summer, was knowing that we were going to be going to ball games. You know, Mom didn't really care for that too much, but
that seven was... kids, kids the games.
And I remember Mom at school and teaching me, and one of my fondest memories of Mother is in grade 3 when I fell on the pencil and got it in my throat. She had to take me to the hospital. And so there I am, nurse hanging on to one arm, Mom hanging, I'm hanging on to Mom with the other arm, and she's got to go back to school. And I got left at the hospital so they could take the pencil out of my throat. And I'll never forget that, but that was one of my highlights of being in Mom's class.
Never forget you coming up the aisle with this thing in your throat and your mouth wide open.
I wish she would have tied me in my desk with my gun holsters that day, but she didn't. And I remember the years of working in the body shop, and then I would get the urge to disappear for a year or so, or 6 months, or something like that. And it was always there for me when I came back, which, you know, was a great issue. Just the fact that they were always there, you know, like Earl said, he always looked forward to coming home. He says, I always was thankful that it was always there when I hit my bottom and I needed some place to go. And that's what I always was grateful for. So,
well, thank you.
Thank you for being there for me.
I'm going to go next.
Okay.
Well, I have a lot of memories too. A lot of them were when nobody was there, because by the time I was growing up, everyone was gone, except for Dennis, a little bit of Dale. I think what they were talking about, the trip, I remember very distinctly a trip across Canada through the mountains with Dennis and I think Dale. And us eating bologna and white bread sandwiches on the in the Rambler. Mm. And then Dennis falling out of the trailer. And being scared by a bear in the Rockies. In a little flimsy trailer like Max sleeping in.
Can I interrupt both,
yes,
Dennis?
Yeah.
We went up to the top of Miette, up and up and up and up and up. And in the middle of the night, we had the Velcro around our trailer. And in the middle of the night, he fell out. And I fell down the mountain. And I ran out of the trailer and I told them, oh, he's gone, he fell down the mountain.